a TV show now, and a film coming out basically about it. We should play with him for a second. Michael.
What do you think? Is that crazy?
No, it's not crazy.
He just wrote a paper 2 days ago about it.
Yeah, I know, sure. See, but my thing was like, if you go back and like, you know, everyone's always like, I wish I had a second chance at something, you know, a mistake they made or something. Like, what if I could do it over again? I believe we can reach a level of consciousness where I don't know if it's knowing how we're going to feel about it in the future or if it's some kind of weird, like, time-lapse thing.
No, you can do it. It's easy. Okay, so here's the reality. All that exists is the present.
Right.
All that exists is the present. That's
all it is.
We're aware of that, right? So what is the past? For you right now, what is the past? The
past is only what I remember.
Exactly. It's your memories. Oh. And what are your memories? Okay, what's your memories are.
Storage.
It's somewhere up here, right?
Yeah. It's all in the mind.
So not necessarily in a linear fashion.
I don't believe time.
Whatever.
So you got your memory stored right now. Consider now the nature of your memories, okay? That's all you have in the past. You can remember what happened a day ago. A minute ago would be even sharp. But a day ago, you know, like, we start to see whatever, right? Now think about 10 years ago. Think about 10 years ago. Right? Time goes like this.
Right.
According to perception.
Sure.
So, but this is something more. This thing's like something, the reality of this moment is much more vivid and real than any memory you can have. So now the same goes for the future. Future is, you can predict probably what's going to happen.
Sure.
A minute from now.
Based on, like, you can see a pattern in the past leading up and predict. Like on IQ tests, you fill in the pattern.
It's like gaming.
Yeah.
That's right, yeah. Well, all future projections are based on history. So what prophecy is based upon is understanding, like, probability, understanding about what's most probable based on what happens. So it's an easy thing to understand. But so getting to the arc, you know, the future, it's as amorphous, unreal as your memories are. So you're thinking about what you have in the future. Like, you know, what do you have in the future? Right now.
Probably gonna get some sushi.
So some thoughts, right?
Yeah.
Some dreams, visions maybe, ideas.
Yeah.
They're somewhere up here, right?
Right.
There's a relationship between the future, you know, your concept of the future, and more than time. So meaning, you can predict what's gonna happen a minute from now. Well, we can predict what's gonna happen 5 minutes from now.
Because it starts to.
Yes.
The
present moment is
the 10 years.
Yes. So now 10 years from now, it gets less and less real, right?
So let
me finish this quick little dissertation. So you exist at the center of your observation of time.
Sure.
At all times. You constantly exist in the eternal now. Always. As this goes for time, so it goes for space. Consider, you know, the universe. If you consider, like, go out of your head and then up into the earth, look at the atmosphere, turn around, look out into space. Do you know how far that goes?
How space goes?
Yeah. Do you know how far that direction goes?
Infinity.
That's right. That's the answer. That's right. Now think about it from forward, facing forward. You know, now go off the trajectory of the Earth, go into space, turn around. You know, it goes on infinitely.
Yeah.
So, you know, behind you, to the left of you, to the right of you, you know, an X, Y, and Z axis, you actually exist at the center of infinity. Or your observation of infinity at all times. So you exist at the observation of infinity and at the observation of eternity at all times.
You mentioned a like time being like a line. I see it more as either like a wheel, either where the center is.
Sphere.
I was going to say sphere.
It's spherical propagation with a spiral dynamic. Have you seen this guy that completed Einstein's work? Dr. Nassim Harriman? I'm going to show you some of his trip balls when you see it. So figured out some
pocket.
Yeah. Yeah, if you can get hold of the DVD. I mean, it's about 6 hours of his whole theory.
Unadulterated.
Fantastic, simple models of the universe.
I'll show you something on that right now. Yeah,
it's phenomenal.
Yeah, but he discovers something intrinsic to the way the nature of time and space
are. Yeah, it's so simple and elegant for you.
That's the truth. That's the litmus test of the truth. It's simple, actually. You know, like, nature is so simple. You know, like,
but not too simple.
Not too simple. It's simple, elegance, kind of simple. It's my buddy coined it, kind of simplexity. No, that's good. It adheres to the principles of simplicity. Yeah. It means it's infinitely simple, but it's so simple that it's you know, complicated or complicatedly organized. Nature's so elegant. Look at that. You have to, like, you know, look at flies' eyes. It's so deeply complicated, but so simple at the same time. And imagine how it perceives consciousness. So I was trying to make a dissertation. Check this out. If you lie at the center of infinity and eternity, do you know that? Do you know what infinity plus 1,000 is?
Still.
That's right. Do you know infinity plus 10,600,000 is?
Still.
Do you know infinity plus infinity is?
Alright, this is a good question. Is there a different answer now?
No, it's easy.
Same
infinity? That's right.
Okay.
Thus, you can only have one infinity.
Yeah.
Right? So it goes for eternity. You can't have time or eternity. It's just this.
Yeah.
Right? Just, you know, remember what the people's description is of God? It's infinite and eternal. Right? But you can only have one infinity.
Yeah.
So we just described that you exist at the center of infinity, right?
Sure.
And you exist at the center of eternity?
Sure.
You exist at the center of God in all times.
Right.
Every one of us does.
Yeah.
And so you, as you journey towards your center, you can actually experience the center point of propagation. To the center of creation, basically, the center of creation, which is really fascinating. If you really, really begin to tangibly understand, you know, like, you know, all you have to do is expand your consciousness beyond the boundaries of your skin to consider who you are in the matrix of everything. You realize you're at the center of infinity and eternity at all times. Think of it like a sphere. You're at the center of everything. So if you journey towards your center, as I say, the kingdom of God lies within, or the divine lies within, or the work of God lies within, that's what exists at the center of everything.
Right. Here's an interesting thing, and this is just in terms of finiteness. Right now, just on this globe that we're on, we're moving at 24,000 miles per hour. That's the circumference.
Okay.
So that means we got to go 1,000 miles. 24,000 is 1,000 miles per hour than we're moving. The Earth, okay, within its orbit around the Sun, is moving something on the order of, I think it's like 65,000 miles per hour. The Sun is moving through the galaxy, through the Milky Way. And the Earth is going around the Sun, and the Sun is moving, and this is how the Earth is moving. And it's also spinning on its axis.
Yeah.
The number is close to a million miles per hour that we're moving right now.
Wow.
But yet, we're at the center, we don't feel it.
Yeah.
Or we feel it, but we've adapted such that we're able to function.
Yeah.